dangerous conditions at a luxury hotel in Midtown Manhattan, a hotel that's been turned into a public shelter for migrants. These are not the conditions most would expect from New York, which proudly proclaims its status as a sanctuary city. So who's responsible for all this? City officials? The migrants themselves? Or perhaps, oh, there's Senator Side investigative reporter Kristen Thorne.
Felipe Rodriguez is in the housekeeping department at the Row Hotel in Midtown and told us the accumulating garbage is only a small part of what workers there are dealing with. New York City is using the 28-story, 1,300-room luxury hotel as a shelter for migrants, some of whom are seeking asylum. Rodriguez says workers are constantly seizing hot plates, pots, and pans from the rooms, even though the city doesn't allow them there because they're a fire hazard.
If those hot plates got you on fire, this whole hotel would go down in flames.
This housekeeping attendant, who did not want to be identified, says every day she finds cooking appliances in the rooms.
It's every day you'll find someone cooking. You can smell the eggs and rice that they're making. It's just bad. It's like they burn the carpets with the hot plates.
Workers say there's also evidence of migrants drinking alcohol in the rooms, which the city says is not allowed. Rodriguez says these pictures were taken inside one of the rooms.
Do you see open beer cans, signs of drinking?
Yes, the empty beer bottles and cans are all over the hallway.
Everybody is working in an environment that's hostile. The stress is crazy.
A city spokesperson said in a statement, "Safety and security of clients and staff are our top priority, and we have security at every humanitarian relief center 24 hours a day, every day."
I see the National Guard in there.
Yes, yes, they're standing right there.
When did they arrive here? When did that start happening?
They arrived here shortly after I complained with HR.
The city says the National Guard is there to assist with management. Workers say they're also concerned about their health. The hotel puts up this list of rooms where people are supposed to be isolating for 21 days for infectious diseases.
But I've seen and witnessed them come out the room when it was a quarantine room, and they're not supposed to do that.
The city says it has a dedicated team who does wellness checks for those in isolation and ensures food delivery to them.
Security is there. They walk around, yes, but there's no one standing by the door, so it's very easy to just leave.
The manager for the hotel did not want to speak with us. The management company, Highgate, did not return our emails. I reached out to the union representing the workers' Local 6. They said the union has always been supportive of putting migrants in underused hotels in the city. The union, though, would not comment on the workers' allegations.